If you want to build a search engine, keyword search is the most natural first attempt. What you would do is say, okay, there's two or three keywords that I'm looking for, and you'd find the documents which exactly match those terms. But that's really brittle. There's multiple ways to say the same thing. If you actually try to search a catalog of movies for Rocky IV, you're probably not going to find the movie you want, because the title of Rocky IV is actually Rocky IV with IV, the Roman numeral. So keyword matching would not find Rocky IV, because you'd probably say the number or maybe F-O-U-R. Another way it breaks is polysemy. The same word can actually mean multiple things. The word bank could mean like financial bank, or it could mean a river bank. When we're looking at these needs, we realize the amount of data is growing exponentially. People just want to search with their voice, search with their phones, talk to Siri or Cortana in natural language, ask a question and get an answer. So as deep learning became more prevalent, we applied it to some of these problems that keyword search wasn't working for and realized this is the solution. But we needed a more efficient platform to actually be able to do this search efficiently. And that's why we built vector search.
With the recent breakthrough of deep learning, the content such as image and text can be more meaningfully represented by a vector. When users send a query to Bing, the query is encoded into a vector. The vector is then searched against hundreds of billions of vectors to find the most relevant results within a digital millisecond. This speed is only possible by using an algorithm called approximate nearest neighbor. This algorithm uses data structure such as a balanced k-means tree and a relative neighborhood graph to accelerate the search process.
Vector search basically makes searching a lot more natural and intuitive, and you search by the concept rather than by the keywords. A really good example is if I ask, how tall is the tower in Paris? You're looking for an answer that says, the Eiffel Tower height is 1,000 feet. I think vector search is just this enabling technology, and it's really just about your creativity on what you can do. And that's why we're open sourcing it. With vector search, we were able to do all sorts of things in Bing. It enabled question answering, celebs like me, image search, visual search. So we think if we give it to the community, other people can actually use it and build their own search around vector search. We work really hard on this algorithm, really proud of it. We'll continue to keep working on it, but we thought, why not give it to the community and see, like, maybe they'll contribute back, and we work on this vector search thing together.